It started peacefully enough with a carnival protest through the streets of South London. More than 20,000 demonstrators, the organisers claimed, were drumming out their message that the campaign against the poll tax is alive and kicking. The police were out in large numbers as well, anxious to avoid a repeat of the violence of the Trafalgar Square poll tax protest 7 months ago, when more than 300 people were arrested. And speakers at this afternoon's rally, including Tony Benn, were confidently claiming that the event had been a success.
Today's demonstration shows that this government is on the ropes. Mass non-payment is a reality. The poll tax will be the major issue at the next general election. If the government doesn't back down, then they will go down with the poll tax.
But later, peaceful protests turned to confrontation. A large group of demonstrators mounted a mass picket outside Brixton prison, where some of those arrested at Trafalgar Square are being held. Police say the trouble started when the crowd refused to disperse and officers moved in to clear the road. The picket organizers say the police were being provocative. The violence continued as the demonstrators were forced back towards Brixton town center. A number of petrol bombs were thrown and a police motorbike was set alight. For a short period this evening, the heart of Brixton was a battleground. The local underground station was shut down. In the shopping centre, some protesters formed barricades from market stalls. Officers in riot gear moved in swiftly to take them down. Five members of the public and six police officers were injured today. 120 people have been arrested. And another poll tax protest has made the wrong kind of...
Westminster through South London, which proceeded without incident. More than 5,000 people gathered at a rally in Brockwell Park, where there were only two arrests. But trouble erupted when about 300 protesters moved on to demonstrate outside Brixton Prison, with the violence spilling into the surrounding streets.
The streets of London once again became a battleground when a rally against the poll tax deteriorated into violence between police and protesters. It was an ugly affair, which even included petrol bombs. The deployment of riot police was in marked contrast to events earlier in the day. Then hundreds of police marshalled the demonstration, some 7,000 strong, and kept it away from the city, remembering the riot in Trafalgar Square last March. And in a Brixton park, many in the crowd heeded a call to picket the local prison, where three men are on remand for alleged offences in Trafalgar Square. The breakaway group was kept away from the jail by police, but tensions grew quickly. Bottles and cans were thrown, and when police moved in to snatch the offenders, a confrontation was inevitable. There were nearly 100 arrests in 2 hours of rioting, and both sides suffered injuries. Eventually, police numbers and tactics forced the demonstrators to disperse, albeit defiantly.
The information we received shows that the police have provoked an incident. Whatever has happened tonight does not affect what happened during the course of the day.
Later tonight, police are expected to hold a news conference to give their version of events.